Welcome to the NoteSpire Music Artist Insight Podcast, giving you a unique insight into the music and ministries of independent Christian artists. Here's your host, Paul Gibbs.
Thank you very much, Bob, and welcome everyone to another episode of the Artist Insight. I have got, friends, I've got the honor and pleasure of talking all the way across the country, well, just about. It's over the other end, and you folks get the blessing of listening in as we talk over the phone with Josh Snyder from Montana. He's in the center of central Montana. I think he said like Lewistown or Lewis something, right,
yep,
Josh?
Yep, Lewistown.
Okay,
yep, Lewistown.
Where no one has ever heard of that. Probably 99.9% of our listeners have never been there. Probably never will go there. But you know what? It's an important place. Because, well, God has put you there. So, yeah.
Honor and pleasure, huh?
Amen.
Thank you.
Right. I'm not sure if that came out right, but that's it's a smile to get us off on a humorous foot here. Anyway, yeah. Josh, thank you so much for being taking your time to talk with us. You've got some great things that we're going to be talking about. You got any God Vibes EP series with some songs that we're going to be sharing. I have got your Facebook page up here on the computer screen, and Josh Snyder Music. Now, friends, I'd like to say up front, if you can't stay with us for the whole interview and you're saying, okay, I got to go, but who is he talking to again? So Josh Snyder, J-O-S-H, Snyder, S-N-Y-D-E-R. And you can find him on Facebook at Josh Snyder Music on Facebook. And I think you're other places too, right, Josh?
Yeah, a little bit of everywhere. Okay. Music's digitally released, Spotify, iTunes, YouTube, a bunch of digital outlets, the mainline ones. And then you'll find us socially on Facebook and Instagram.
Yeah.
Now we're on TikTok. So if you're into that, you know, head over and check out TikTok.
Sweet. Okay. All right, friends, there you go. So if you can't stay with us, look him up anywhere online, Josh Snyder Music. All right, Josh, so we got, excuse me, we'll get to one of your songs here in a couple minutes, but tell me at least, I mean, maybe other people are curious, or maybe they really don't even care, but about Montana and where you are. I know before we started recording, you said you're in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, basically, we're 2 hours both ways to the nearest Walmart, and we have lots of mountains and valleys and rivers and lakes. It's a beautiful place. If you like nature, if you like hunting, if you like fishing, you'll find all of that up here.
Really?
Yeah. Get lost in Montana is that popular slogan that kind of hails from our area. And and if you want, you can come up here and get lost. But we encourage most people to just, you know, it's actually not that good. Stay out. We're full enough. Please don't come visit. You know, it's gonna but and during the pandemic, I think a lot of people took hold of the idea of let's go check out some new place, and there's been people pouring in from everywhere, it seems like. So,
really?
So Montana's got some stuff that people desire, quiet, you know, place, and maybe if this keeps up it won't be so quiet, but lots of beautiful parts of the United States kind of are all represented up here. Plus we have all four seasons generally pretty distinctly, including a very harsh winter at times. So
right.
Yeah.
So I bet you're now. I'm in southern Pennsylvania, but I'm from upstate New York, as our listeners know, about 200 miles south of the Canadian border, what we call the Adirondack Mountains. I'm wondering. I'm not looking at a map, of course, but I'm wondering if, of course, up there we have all four seasons as well. And we have it here in Pennsylvania, but the winter is a little milder here where we are. But I mean, the four seasons, I mean, you know, Frankie Valli excluded, is, you know, kind of a nice thing to enjoy all that.
Keeps you content wherever you're at. I mean, at least most of the time. So, you know, the summer, we're all wishing for summer in the middle of winter, and then the summer hits, and we're wishing for fall and a little cooler, and then the fall hits. And, you know, so maybe some people are just running in circles with it all, but and maybe it goes to show that the heart of man is never satisfied under the sun, but I enjoy the variety of the seasons and being able to see all that beauty unfold here where I'm blessed to be living right now. So,
amen. I agree. I don't think that I could be without the four seasons either. So Josh, let's talk about your music. So, when did you start? What was your first instrument and when?
Guitar, and I was probably 12. I picked it up. My dad knew a little bit of guitar, and he pulled out a little guitar book and gave it to me and said, here, check this out. And the way he puts it is I took leaps and bounds over what he had, and I just kept running with it. And that's my primary instrument even today. I play both acoustic and electric. Mm-hmm. Very similarly played, but they I've been meaning to learn some other instruments. I actually picked up the mandolin and learned some simple chords on the mandolin and the bass guitar. But in regards to instrument variety, I've been trying to lately been focusing a lot more on getting my vocals, my voice where it needs to be. So, guitar is probably the primary instrument, and that's the one that I bring to the table. And then my drummer for Josh Snyder Music brings some awesome dynamics drumming and harmonizes along with the music. If you check out some of the new music and stuff, you'll hear him in the background there as well.
Very cool. We'll talk about him in just a minute. But did you pick up a lot of people? Well, I shouldn't say a lot of people. I don't know. I'm not always interested. No, I picked up an electric guitar first, and I didn't play an acoustic guitar. Of course, back then we called them folk guitars. No, you play a Strat. You don't. What's folk guitar? No, you don't touch that. That's for
you want to rock.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, it was Beatles, Monkees, Stones. The British stuff for me back in the 60s, early 70s. But anyway, did you pick up an electric or acoustic at first?
First was acoustic, definitely the progression was to an electric, and what you hear now on the tracks is kind of where the variety is culminated, and it's been cool to see how it's all built up.
Right. So what were your first influences as far as music groups?
Toby Mac was probably the top. Like, honestly, I loved what he did with DC Talk and DC Talk all around, like their music, that style. I love the versatileness. If you listen to my older stuff and even some of the newer stuff, you'll see that there's not like a distinct genre I stick to. And sometimes it may not be good for trying to promote to a certain audience, but I love variety. I love being able to, I love listening to variety. And so maybe one person might not like certain songs that I put out and like others, but that's okay. I mean, I love doing what I do. And so variety's huge. And so I see that in Toby Mac and DC Talk. And then recently in the last probably 4 or 5 years, I've been really, I love listening to For King and Country. Really, top Christian band, really solid duo. Yes. And I love the variety in instruments. I love their passion and their performance on the stage, and I'm just trying to find ways to build that into not just behind the mic in a studio, but into live performances and stuff that we do. So
right, amen. And I think it's not using about variety. I think that if you whether you stick to one style or you don't, what's even more important than the style, I think, especially when you're doing different styles, trying to be put a little variety into it, is your passion, and people sense that. That's, they know that.
Yeah.
And whatever style you happen to be doing, and you can be up there. You can be up there doing a music program, and you can go from one style of song right to another, and people will come right along with you if they see that you are enjoying, that you are ministering, that you are, that you are really into it. They're going to be into it as well. Yeah.
And if it sounds like cleanly put.
Yes. Yep. Cleanly put together. And right. Well, let's get to one of your songs, Josh. You sent these to me. These songs are going to be appearing. Yeah. These songs are going to be airing on NoteSpire Radio and on our weekly podcast, the Just Got Music Hour. And so let's start with Feel It. And what do you want to say about this song before we play it?
One of the first professionally done music videos. Actually, I should say the first professionally done music video we've done. I've produced and recorded and done my own in the past, but this one we had a company take hold of it, and so he sent me over the rough draft for it, and I'm excited to put this thing out there. The songs on this new EP is one of the more upbeats and jams, as some people might call it. Right. It's a bop, and might find yourself tapping your foot a little bit, moving your leg around a little bit. I don't know, however you want to express it, but I hope you feel the passion, the desire for of Christ and the things that he would have for us, and the message centers around God's power being so evident in many of us as Christians' lives, that And the end of the chorus comes back and asks the question, why would I run away from his love when we can feel it right here? Like, the idea is we've seen him move. We've seen him do things in our life. He's changed us. And then sometimes we find ourselves walking away from that as if it never even happened, or pushing against God's will. And so this song comes back to the roots of that and asking, you know, if you've seen God move in your life,
yeah,
why would you push against that? You know that the greatest place to be in this life is right where God wants you. And so this song is hopefully an anthem and a challenge to stay right there.
Yeah, I like that. I like that. Here we go with Josh Snyder and Feel It.
Place in a time, no reason or rhyme. I was living my life. I realized I was living a lie, and the devil tried to hold me in my demise. Brainwashed, singing everything's groovy, hoping everything would end up like the movies. Get rich, get the girl, get famous, just like that. Ride into the sunset.
Knocking on my door, my heart just hit the floor. I need you more and more. You give me real life. Don't make my sin a shame. Sinning in your name, I'll never be the same.
Yeah, I'm changed.
Wow, that's powerful. Can you feel it? Do you feel it? You should be feeling it. And if after that song you don't feel it, turn it up louder.
Go back and listen to it again.
Listen to it again. Exactly. I like that.
You can find that in the music video here very soon on YouTube and iTunes and Spotify and all those other places. So
great. Awesome. Okay, so let's talk about the other guy that I see at the top of the screen on your Facebook page with his hat on backwards. Who's that?
That's Ike Danford. He's hails from Indiana. where most of my family is originally from. And he moved up to Lewistown, Montana about a year and a half ago now. And we crossed paths, and the rest is history. But no, we started making music together, working, messing around with some things. We figured we both have a passion for music, and he's got some talents where I don't have talent, specifically in the area of drumming and vocal harmony, and being able to pick up and sing almost by ear based on the note that I'm putting out. He can sit there and find the harmony note for it and just do it. So it was pretty cool. And so he brings a lot to the table to what we're building, and we're excited just to be like just recently start including him in live shows and traveling, and then of course on the track when we're recording in the studio. So the God Vibes Part 1 was released almost 2 years ago. The pandemic and a few other reasons kind of weighed in on why the second one was not bursted out a lot quicker, but. The if you go back and listen to that God of Ice Part 1, you won't hear him on that. So yeah, he's so recent that his first performances will be on God of Ice Part 2.
Okay.
Back in the background, and on the song Feel It, as you just heard that second verse, that was Ike taking hold of that second verse, and he and I wrote that one together. And and actually that second verse, the funny story behind Feel It, real quick, we'll move on, but yep. There's a funny story behind Feel It. I took about a year and a half to write that, and the reason being is I had the first verse, the chorus, and the bridge all bridge. Written out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I couldn't get a second verse. I just was sitting there getting writer's block and started a few things and just didn't work, and it just didn't feel right. And so I reached out to a few artist friends to kind of take a look at it and tell me what they think, and I had like three people who were supposed to either feature on it. There's three of them that were supposed to feature on it. And then one guy who took a look and wrote some things and didn't finish it either. And finally on the third try, we just basically took this second verse from a music artist named Josh Feta. He's been featured on, I don't know if he's been on your show, but
I've heard his name.
Yeah. I know you're connected with Joseph Neal over at the Christian Media Spotlight.
Yes.
And he plays across their feed quite often.
Okay.
So anyway, Josh Feta took a hold of the song and wrote out a second verse. And so he wrote the majority of the second verse that you hear on Feel It. And then our drummer Ike has a unique voice, and we thought it'd mix well into that and give it a nice flair for the second, because I like a variety, as I've said before. And
right.
So, he hopped on there and got the second verse recorded and finally got out to the finished product, and we're happy to share it. So,
Wow. Okay. So it's you and, you said Ike came in kind of more recently, but before that, who else is involved in what you do?
Before that, I had in regards to live shows and touring, I had a little small group of roadies who ran around with me and set up for little shows and stuff. But honestly, before that, it was just myself, some fog, some lights, a little mixing station, and that was it.
Sure.
I was solely independent and trying to run with and work with what I had. And
that's cool. Yeah.
And now that Ike's on board, there's a little bit more flair and variety to not only the music behind the track or on the track, but on stage. And so we're excited to roll out some new shows and new feel to these shows.
Yeah. So if people see a live show, they're going to see you guys. Do you do any tracks, Josh, or is it just, I don't say just you and Ike doing the live stuff.
What do you mean by do any tracks?
Is there any background tracks when you guys do?
Yeah. So when you perform, we mix background with instruments. So we've got certain parts in the instrumental that we can't play mixed on there. And then I pull the guitar and he's got the drums, and sometimes they'll throw in like a piano or something like that. So
yeah. Awesome. Awesome. Yep. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. That makes it nice. And if you, some artists will do some to tracks and some just instrument only and then a mixture. So I think, as you said, I think that variety is kind of nice. It breaks it up for the audience and for us as artists as well. Yeah.
Yep, for sure.
Let's take a quick pause, Josh, and we'll do a little station identification here, and then let's come back and talk about the next song, which will be Chains. We will be right back with Josh Snyder.
We'll be right back with more of the NoteSpire Radio Artist Insight right after this. You're listening to another Artist Insight on WNSMDB NoteSpire Radio.
And we are back with Josh Snyder Music. Oh, Josh, it's great talking to you all the way across the country. I was talking to a guy just the other day, which his interview will air just before yours. He was all the way out in the state of Washington. And so we get to talk to, and I've done a couple interviews with people over in the UK. So it's, I just think it's awesome. You know, Josh, Jesus told his disciples that they would do even greater things than he would. And, you know, it's kind of hard to wrap our minds around sometimes, spiritually speaking, of course, it's not true in one sense that we can perform miracles. Well, actually, I guess some do, but it's all with God's power. But the disciples, they walked everywhere. They didn't touch the whole world personally the way that we can now with the technology that God has provided. I just think I think it's an awesome thing, and that's great to be a part of it. Yeah. So, Josh,
for sure.
Go ahead.
For using all the tools that God gives us to take hold of and run with them. I mean, it's we have opportunity, and I think sometimes that's a bittersweet because it makes us lazy too.
True.
If we take hold of the opportunity, we can see some great things done.
For sure. Yeah. I think that's I like what you said. In fact, let's just expand on that just a little bit. And sometimes we think, well, if we let somebody else do it, or so and so is reaching a gazillion people online, a gazillion plays on, whatever, streams on Spotify, and look at me, I only got 5 or 10, whatever, so why bother? But, but no, friends, we got to use what God has given you. And I think, maybe we might come back and touch on that subject a little bit before we get done. Well, let's get this next song, because this next one is called Chains, and I listened to a little bit of this before we started recording tonight, and I love this. I love this because it just says again that our chains are broken when we, Jesus has that power to break whatever chains that we have around us that maybe the enemy is throwing on us. And why don't you take that and run with it a little bit more, and then we'll play the song.
Yeah, I started writing the song under the mindset that I want to take this spiritual warfare and put it to song, at least to some degree. And if you listen to all the songs, you'll find a spiritual element, the warfare going on and being enraging and being put forth to music in all of them. But this one, I just kind of imagined to start off on a darker note where things are just, I'm sick. I'm trapped. I'm trapped in my mind. I'm trapped in this place and crying out in maybe the storm of my life, and God coming in and showing me what to do and have faith and unlocking those chains, and I can cast them off in Jesus' name, because we have that power. We've got the power, like you said a moment ago, like greater things than these will be done. Like we're not necessarily always on like the physical level, but man, there's so much more going on the spiritual level.
Yeah.
Like we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and the rulers of this dark world. I mean, like we are at war, and this song is a battle cry and an anthem of victory in Christ. And so, I hope you like the song Chains. I hope it means something, and I hope you come back and listen to it again and check it out online. It's out now everywhere.
Amen. Okay, folks, here we go. It's a great battle cry. I like that, Josh. Here we go. Josh Snyder and Chains.
Got me feeling so sick, trying to break out of this dark. Want to know your love, Lord, so can you heal this broken heart? Never did I ever see you right in front of me, so I'm reaching for you now. This love, how can it be? So much truth, but so many lies. So much evil in disguise. Mind is messed up, heart is blind. I wanna know truth, I'll seek and find.
We'll be right back with more of the NoteSpire Radio Artist Insight right after this. You're listening to another Artist Insight on WNSMDB NoteSpire Radio.
WNSMDB.
Okay, and, oh my goodness. Yeah, chains. Yeah, breaking my chains, taking my chains off. Oh, yeah, we can't, I don't think we can talk enough about that because so many people are in bondage of one type or another. Let's take that, Josh, and talk about, I want to make sure we touched on this, this whole pandemic thing that, you know, of the past year or more, how has that has put chains on a lot of people in many different ways, to one extent or another, I believe. So how has that affected what you have done as far as music goes?
A setting aside the inconvenience of it, just, you know, being like to where I couldn't do live shows and book those things. Mm-hmm. And we were in the middle of booking the God Vibes tour, the first stretch of it, back when this all was setting in, the beginning of last year. And so, of course, it put a damper on the majority of anything we were able to do and in that regard. But, there's just a darkness that came with it because there was, you know, there's just widespread fear, the widespread confusion, because honestly, I mean, with all that was being said on the news and all that, I mean, there's just who knows what to believe and how to believe it and how to take it, or right. Should we do this or should we not do this as a church? Yeah. Should we close down? Should we open up? Do we care about people? What does it mean to care about people? And all these confusing questions that most of us haven't had to ask at this widespread level. At least not to where everyone else is asking them out loud.
Right.
And so there's, I think it reflected a lot of what was going on maybe already inside, many of us, and also showed us how volatile what we put our trust in is. And I think as we move forward, we might even see more of that.
Yeah.
Like where our treasure is, there our heart will be also. And that can be taken two ways. The second way, one way that people say is, you know, put your treasure put your heart where your treasure is, like you're going to invest in what you love and things like that. But the other way you can take it is kind of the other end, is like where your heart's going to be, you're going to find your treasure there. And most of us have our treasure in things that corrupt and rust and thieves break through and destroy, and pandemics corrupt and, you know, and so I think as Christians, it was a good reminder and still is, of where's our faith and where's our trust in, even if we don't know the answer, like, 'cause sometimes I think we get caught up and think we have to know every single answer to every issue that gets thrown out and every tragedy. And sometimes we step back and say, God, I don't know. I don't understand. But I want to become a better person because of this. And I want to be more like you because of this. And even if I never understand it. And, I've seen many things like that in my life, especially over my younger and middle-aged teenage years, where I was fighting against the spirit and things that I knew I should be doing and could have taken hold of, because it's not like I didn't have a good upbringing. I grew up in a preacher's home, and so I had some great influence. I had great truth accessible, and I cast aside much of the things that I knew I should be doing or should not have been doing. And I had to go through the school of hard knocks, I think. I didn't have to, but I did.
Yeah, and, right.
And yeah. So life has a way of working itself around to show us that we don't have the wheel, and that and ultimately, if our trust is in man, it'll fail. If our trust is in the economy, it's going to fail. If our trust is in our health and cleanliness, it's going to fail. But, you know, he who puts his trust in the Lord safe as he. You can run to him as a strong tower, no matter what's going on. And I found that to be the most encouraging and strengthening point of this season.
Yeah.
And hopefully for many other seasons to come.
Yeah. Amen. Yeah. I think it's very obvious to most of us. If we don't know it yet, we will. We grow in the hard times. We don't grow when things are easy. So musically, did the last year or so, did that spur you on with music? Did it increase what you were doing musically, or did you kind of withdraw from it?
It spurred me on personally.
Okay.
So when I say that, I mean like it got me writing a lot more. It got me working on this project a lot more. If you listen to this project in comparison to the last one or even the very first one years and years ago that was released. When I say years and years ago, I mean like 4 or 5 years, but you know, it seemed like a long time ago at this point.
Yeah.
If you compare them, you'll find like there's been growth. Like I can hear growth, and other people tell me every time they listen to this compared to the last one, they hear growth and qualities increased and things like that. And it's exciting to see and hear, but I think a lot of that would not have happened if I was just putting out music the way I wanted to, in regards to like how quickly I put it out, in regards to, you know, the budget that I wish I had to keep this running. Cause you know, we're independent and
right.
hopefully we'll be making some money on it eventually, but hey, right. If I never make money on it again, it's still going to be my passion and what I drive and aspire to do. And, over the last year, it's just spurred on other areas that needed work because I had to stop and focus on them because I could not just, you know, do live shows and I could not do certain things that I really wanted to do, but God said slow down. And so it caused me to slow down in that way, but
right.
build and increase and put some quality into some other ways that needed and still probably will continue to be worked on as we move forward.
Yeah. Cool. Did you, I want to ask you, when you couldn't do shows, live shows, did you do some online stuff?
Yeah, we did a couple. We did a full concert online about a year ago. So like at the peak of when everything was shutting down, we did a full concert. And then, we did a few small live performances and stuff between the whole little last year and stuff. So yeah, but at this point we were able to start ramping back into some live shows. Some places still don't want to do anything, but that's okay.
Yeah.
We're excited to see the doors start to open and that opportunity be given to us. We just got back from a show to Kansas, over Burton, the little community of Burton. A few weeks ago, and we did a full EP release concert here in my local town of Lewistown, and that was more well attended than any other show that I've done in the local area yet. We're excited to see the growth and people start to come out of the shell a little bit.
Right. That's good. Yeah. Yeah. Especially in your hometown.
Yeah.
Let's see. Where were we going with that? I guess I was gonna wait on this third song to a couple more minutes. But
we can. I got a few more things here, if you don't mind.
Yeah, please do.
I'd like to maybe wrap up on this last song, but the there's some things upcoming, and we're building to not only produce and put out quality music, but to eventually take it full time. Lord willing, that's our goal. That's our intent. That's our ministry drive.
Right.
And so over the next year, we're looking to continue to book shows, and we're working on booking our next tour. The God Vibes Tour is essentially what it's called. And there's an upcoming release, the third and final installment, at least unless, you know, God pushes us to put some more into God Vibes, but the third and final installment as of now, God Vibes Part 3, with isn't going to studio and getting recorded even now. Over the last few months, we've been working on the third one, and so we're excited. We got more brand new music still in the making, and of course the music video that we're working on to put out there. So we're trying to get quality content and try to reach out and find ways to plug in to any opportunity we get. Even so much so that we would love to be a part of community events, whatever you got going, whether it be a festival, whether it be a youth event, an outreach event. We don't care. We're not picky. Get a hold of me if you want a group that does music and ministry specific and oriented things to come in and even help you out I think one year we went on a tour, a few years ago, I should say, I went on my first tour, the Rise Up tour. I did community-based events whenever I'd go to the town. And so we did community-based events in Burton, Kansas, for example. And we painted a bathroom at their local park and did some cleanup around the community over in Washington. A couple of places in Washington a few years back when we were there doing shows. And we just want to plug in and serve wherever we can. It's not just on the stage, but off the stage. And especially with these times now where there's a lot of people just in need of something.
Yeah.
We're not picky. We want to be of service, and we don't just want to be the guys that sing and run. So that's kind of been our goal, especially since we're small and we have the ability to flex a little bit more.
Yes.
We can do that, so.
Yep. I like that because so many of the quote unquote big time artists, they just, the bus pulls into town. They do their thing, get back on a bus and move on to the next one. And you can never even touch them. You can't, you can't talk to them. You can't, unless you get a backstage pass or something. But, I was out there doing the church thing and traveling around and things. And I tell you what, I started out like, only 5 people, only 10 people. It took me a little bit to learn, you realize, that those small churches, for example, they can't bring in the big names. They might want to, but they can't afford it, but they can. And I like to tell other artists what I had to learn was, you're there for a reason. And, I like it what you said. You're not there just to minister in music, but when you use your gifts, your other gifts in different ways, even if it's just listening to somebody. I tell you, some of the greatest ministry times I had was just, listening to someone's story after, over a chocolate chip cookie and some coffee after the concert. Somebody just want to come up and they can't do that with somebody else. I'm sure you guys have. Is there one incident maybe that comes to mind where that might have happened for you? I'm putting you on the spot, aren't I?
Yeah, I was thinking about the parable of the talents, and that's a little mind just going off somewhere else. So the idea that God gives us specific things, and the number isn't necessarily important, but it's what you do with it.
Right.
And specifically, I think back to an event that we did it's about 4 years ago now in my local town, and we built up this event. I was one of the openers to a bigger and more well-known band from Washington. They were called The Exchange at the time, but they had that high quality music, full band with very talented Christian young men who did music. And we built this event up for 6 months. And then the day before, we got a call saying that their lead singer, Britt, I think it was Britt. Anyway, he had ruptured something inside. I mean, it wasn't good. He was in the ER for like 2 or 3 days. And so, they were like, they were en route to Montana and they had to call it off. And so we sat there like kind of stunned because of how long and how much we put into this and ticket sales and all this stuff. And, we started praying. I just remember asking God, I don't know what's going on here. And I don't know what you want to do with this. Would you have us do more? Would you have us go out and like still do something and do something different? And as we prayed, we didn't get any answers that night. And I went to bed kind of bummed out. And my buddy who was helping me, put it on. One of them that's helped me put it on left. And he said, I something along the line of, I think God's going to do something. We don't know what yet. And so the next morning I woke up and had some people messaging me in my Facebook inbox saying, hey, is the concert off? What's going on here? What do you got going on here? And I opened up the messages and I started to reply, and I didn't finish the reply. And maybe you could blame it on the fact that I was just feeling pretty bummed out, and it was like 7 a.m. or something. I just got back into bed and went back to sleep.
Yeah.
And I woke up at like 10 and I had a message from the coordinator of the whole event, the guy who is like sponsoring it and behind me. And he left me a message and he said, get out of bed, wake up, show's back on, give me a call back. by, and I gave him a call back. And so there's a group called the Circuit Riders. They travel around to like colleges and campuses and things like that, and perform full concerts and do like revival meetings and stuff. And they had all, they were a Christian rock pop praise and worship based band, and they had a full set of instruments. They had all their sound equipment.
Wow.
And they were in the area for the one weekend that they had off during their tour.
Staying
in Lewistown, and somebody got wind over to them that this event had been canceled that was scheduled for the one night, the one full day they had off. And they're like, yeah, let's pray about this. And so they pray about it, and like immediately they call back and say, yeah, we're here for this.
Great.
Like, this is why we're here. And so we got to actually offer everyone their money back and actually be able to offer the event for free that night. So quite a few people got to come along that maybe heard about it short notice or didn't have you know, 10, 15 bucks that they wanted to put into a ticket, but they came along just to see what God was doing with this weird event that got canceled and reset and had a new headliner band overnight and all this stuff. Like, it was an amazing thing to be a part of. And I say all that just to say, trust God. It may not end up like that. And maybe God would have, you know, and next time God will have us just do a little concert at our church and be able to minister to a few people that need some individual counseling or individuals, you know, speaking on an issue or something. But you know, trust God through it all. Use your time, talent, and treasure to glorify Him, and He'll work out the pieces the way He sees best. And ultimately, the God who sees the picture, the full picture, can work things out a lot greater than we can, even if we think we've got it all together.
Yeah, that's right. He always sees the bigger picture than we do. That's for sure.
Yeah.
Wow. What a testimony. What a story. That's great. Okay, so we got one more song to get to, Josh.
Yeah.
Hearts
so
Cry.
This song is probably, it's doing the best on the EP. It's got a very radio-ish feel, so it's pop-based. It doesn't have some extra weird flares that I like to put into my music, but I do love this song and the message behind it. So it's a little more laid-back in style and stuff compared to a lot of stuff that I put out, but it is truly my heart cry. I started writing this song in the car. I wasn't writing it because I was driving, but I started repeating the chorus in my mind after it started formulating because of some thoughts and some things that I just couldn't shake. You know, God, why would you forgive me again? Why would you, you know, why is this grace so, is your grace so amazing? Why, you know, and my cry was, God, forgive me once again, bring me back to the start. I know I've messed up. I know I feel like a failure. I know you look at me, and if I was you, I would look at me as a failure. But through the eyes of grace, through the eyes of what your son did, through that lens, you see forgiven, you see redeemed, you see me for who I am in you, a child of God. And so this is my heart cry.
Amen. Amen. Here we go, friends. Josh Snyder, Heart Cry.
Sit down and kick up my feet in this war. But then your voice, a voice so loving and so strong, whispers in my ear and reminds me of who I belong.
Take this ride.
hoe to grace, how great a debtor. Daily I'm constrained to be. Let thy goodness, like a fetter, bind this wandering heart to thee.
Cause I'm just so
prone to wander, Lord, I feel it. Prone to leave the God I love. Here's my heart, Lord, take and seal it. Seal it for the courts above.
So run in, run in, run in, come and save me. I need, I need, I need you. Don't hate me. I know, I know, I know I fell from you will. Oh, but my God, my God, my God, send your army. I cry, I cry, I cry out for thee. Walk in me, pick me up, and take this light to the heart. And bring me back to the start again. Bring me back to the start. Bring me back to the start. Bring me back to the start. Bring me back to the start.
Gosh, that's a great, great message. My heart cry. Well, we can sense your heart in that one. Amen.
Thank you.
Yeah, that is great. Well, let's tell people again how they get a hold of you. I'll let you do it. Go ahead.
You can reach out to me, whether it be for booking inquiries, whether it be for questions about the music, or if you just want to know more about God or want to know more, you need somebody to talk to. I'm a fairly busy guy, but I still try to always be able to reply to anybody who reaches out about anything. So you can find me on Facebook. Probably the easiest way to find me is under Josh Snyder Music, or Josh Snyder, if you really, want to get a hold of me personally, you can pull up my personal profile. But Josh Snyder Music, you'll follow that, like that, you'll find the content that comes through there is generally, it's all specifically based around music and things like that. So if you want to follow the movement and help us build this up so where we can do maybe more, go ahead, hop on there and do that. Or your Instagram, if you use that, under Josh Snyder Music.
Mm-hmm.
YouTube, the YouTube channel gets the updated videos when we release them, like the music video that's coming out here very soon. I'm excited to get that out there. And
yeah,
we'll be setting a premiere date here in the probably tomorrow. But it won't be premiering tomorrow, but we'll set the date tomorrow. But anyway.
Right.
So you can get a hold of me that way. Or you can email me at bookjoshsnyder@gmail.com. Again, that's bookjoshsnyder@gmail.com. And that's a great way to reach out about booking inquiries and stuff like that. And again, when it comes to the booking, a lot of people hear the word booking and they think thousands and thousands of dollars or something like that. Or they think, I can't do this. We can't put this together. And I've seen churches with a membership of like 10, mm-hmm, put something together for the community.
Oh, yeah.
And they, their little budget and swung it, and they were able to give us what got us there and helped us out, and we still put on something awesome for the community, and not just because we were there playing music. I don't want to toot my own horn that way, but because it was something that the community needed, and they felt that the outreach and the ministry in that was what was needed for that time. And so if you want to help us grow and get experience and want to meet us, please, yeah, reach out, and we'll just talk. Even if you don't think it's something you might be able to swing anytime soon, start asking questions. I'd love to answer them, and let's see if we can get us to your town, anywhere in the United States at this point. Again, some places might be a little more locked off, especially if you want me to get all the way over to like Pennsylvania or something, because I might need to find a few other shows between here and there to get everything there. So,
yep.
But just reach out and we can go from there.
That sounds good. That sounds good. Friends, I hope you will take a listen. I'm just scrolling down through Josh's music page on Facebook. There's videos there. I'm seeing a video of you playing guitar with another guy playing guitar. I can't really tell who that one is. He's not playing drums. Oh, there's our good friend Joe Neo. Doing an interview. So yeah, Josh is out there, friends, so please do check him out. You're hearing this interview. I don't know where you're hearing. You might be hearing it on our station. You might be hearing it on your favorite podcast site. But if you're hearing it on the station, WNSMDB, NoteSpire Radio, Please be aware that if you want to hear it again, or you didn't, or just want to catch something again, just please do go to your favorite podcast site, and it will be on there. Just search for the NoteSpire Music Artist Insight, or I'm sure, Josh, if they just search your name, eventually, the way the internet works, the Artist Insight interview, this interview is going to come up in that in search results. So, again, yeah. great thing about the technology God has given us. We are going to finish up here. We're going to take a couple extra minutes, Josh, and I forgot to do this. I want to just talk to you real quickly about something, one of the issues that has faced you recently in doing your music ministry, something that somebody else might be facing that you could maybe help them with. Anything come to mind?
Specifically, I think, so we write about things we're passionate about, whether it be our, one of the other songs on the God of Vibes Part 2 EP is a song called Figure Out. And it's a song that I wrote my wife and I kind of collaborated on it a bit together, put it together. It's a song that we wrote about some things that we are working through, and we'll continue to work through. Like the chorus proclaims, I said I do, and I meant that. Mm-hmm. And so walk with me to a place where walls fall down and hope can live again.
Yeah.
Like we, not just in marriage, but in any of our relationships that mean something to us, and our relationship with our friends and our family, like the music all comes back to a real person and real people. And we have things that we're working out. None of us are perfect. I don't want to even come off like I'm perfect.
Right.
We all have addictions, or have had addictions. We all have things that Satan knows where to push under to get under that armor. We all have areas that need work and will continue to need work. And so, I guess I say all that to come back to say, I personally have been fighting a lot against just keeping my mind in Christ. Something I've learned over the last few years, and probably learned earlier, I just never listened. Was the battle always starts in the mind. And that's why scripture is so repetitive on the idea that we're supposed to renew our minds often.
Yes.
Without the renewal of the mind, we're all slowly slipping backwards. We're all slowly slipping towards our desires that are out of line with what actually needs to happen. But we'll all slowly slip into lust and addictive behaviors and things that just will pull us back. And Satan knows it, especially as Christians. Like, he targets those areas.
Yeah.
And to the lost, or to somebody who may not know their eternal security, he uses that flesh to keep those people under the water, to keep them away from the good news of the gospel, keep them away from where God would have them be. And so wherever you're at, I want to encourage you, stay your mind on Christ. If you haven't got to the point where you know where you're going to spend eternity, hey, the Bible says you can know. These things that are written unto you, that you may know that you have eternal life, and it's through Jesus Christ and the faith in what he did alone for you. Like, it's free. Like, it doesn't get any better than that. And so if you haven't got to the point where you've accepted that, you can do so right now. You don't have to be in a church. You don't have to be, you don't even have to be listening to this station. You can turn it off and just cry out to God, God, save me. And then turn the radio back on and finish out the interview. And if you are a Christian, but you find yourself, you're just bumping and running. I mean, I remember, like I said, my teenage years were just a lot of bump and runs, throwing up things that I knew weren't supposed to be there, and then going back and eating them back up. Like the proverb says, as a man returns to his folly, as a dog returns to his vomit, so does a man to his folly.
Yeah.
Like we do that even as Christians. So understand, I'm not perfect, but the best way to fight that battle is up in the mind and cutting it off right there and staying your mind on Christ and renewing it. Was just going to take care of 95% of the things that you're going to face, whether it be COVID related, whether it be addictions, whether it be marital. God can work through that situation, and just keep your mind in Christ. And one good way to do that is get into the Word of God. Open up that Bible, start reading. Ask God to use that Word to enlighten you, and whatever He might have for you that day. And He will. I promise you that.
Yes.
I guarantee it. Even if you don't understand some of the words that are being said at first, man, you just make some of them good habits. Institute a lifestyle of praying more, of giving God who you are, and he'll take that broken life, because we're all broken, honestly. Like, if we all step back and think about it, we've all been broken. He'll take that broken life. He'll mend it back together, and ultimately someday we'll be able to stand before God in Christ and say, I am free, and I am a child of the Most High.
Amen. Amen. Good words, Josh. Thank you. Thank you. That's you hit it right on the head. Yes. Thank you for that. Yeah. All right. Well, we are going to wrap up here. And friends, we thank you for listening to this episode of the NoteSpire Music Artist Insight with Josh Snyder. Please do look him up online, Josh Snyder Music on Facebook and wherever else where great music is streamed and downloaded. You're going to find Josh's music and more coming up real soon. Right, Josh?
Yes, sir. Yep. Stay tuned. Go follow the movement. I'd love to interact and get to know you if you want to reach out.
Amen. Amen. All right. We are going to get off of here. And Josh, thank you again. And we wish you the best. God bless you. And hey, when you got some more music, make sure you send it our way. And hey, let's do this again sometime.
Thank you so much, Paul. I appreciate it.
All right. You're very welcome. Take care now. God bless.
Bye-bye.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Thanks for listening to NoteSpire Radio Artist Insight. We hope you've enjoyed the program today. And join us next time when we again bring you a unique look into the lives, music, and ministries of Christian artists. Here on NoteSpire Radio Artist Insight.